Hello all, welcome to my channel. And in this video, I'll demonstrate you how to implement concept of pacing in JMeter using constant throughput timer as well as shaping throughput timer. So pacing refers to a time gap between each and every iterations in our test scenario. So I have designed four thread groups in this test script. So one is without think time, another is with think time, and the next two where I have implemented the pacing concepts. So let me quickly demonstrate you with this without think time. So here I have used no time gap between each and every request. So in this thread group, once I'll execute this, each and every request will be called subsequently without any gap between any of the requests. So this is my thread properties which I have designed. So I have a two number of threads is 2 and the ramp up between each and every threads is 5 seconds. So as 2 thread and 10 seconds is my ramp up time, and I am executing it for 3 iterations. So I am starting the test. So here in this test, if you look, first of all, within a 5 seconds, all my first thread started and executed all the 3 iteration, and after that 5 seconds the second thread has started and it has also completed its 3 iteration. So there was no time gap between any of the iteration for any of the threads, neither for the thread 1 nor for the thread 2. There were some gap which was because of the ramp up time, which is set to as 5 seconds, and as I have not used any of the timer between each and any of the requests, so there was no gap between the any of the request as well. So if you look into the aggregate report, so I have hit all the requests and the throughput is 2.6 requests per second. So this is the results of my thread group where I have not used any of any think times. So now I'll be executing a script where I have used a think time. So what does a think time means? So it's like whenever we interact with any of the application, a user before performing any of the action, he thinks, he takes some time and he performs some or the other action based upon the response which he gets. So as a user, we usually give some time gap between each and every action, so that is counted as a think time. So for implementing a think time, I have used a random timer and I have used a random delay maximum of 500 milliseconds and a constant delay offset of 500 milliseconds. So as I have disabled this without think time, so now I am executing this with think time and we'll look how the execution goes. Here also, if I'll show you, I have a two threads and a ramp up time is of 10 seconds and a loop count of 3. So I have started my test. So here if you look, the test started. Yes, the thread 1. So yes, thread 1. So in thread 1 also, if you see here, the next iteration started without any time gap. And as I have given some time gap, so after 5 seconds, 48, 43 to 48. So after 5 seconds, the second thread also got initialized and it started also working. But here also we cannot see any gap between any of the iteration. So first thread started, I have hit this unknown request and again this unknown request was hit. So there was no gap between iterations of a first thread, though we can see a gap between the threads as a ramp up time, which is implemented by the ramp up time. So let's see the aggregate report which I got. So here the aggregate report is of 1.2 request per second. Earlier we had around 2.6 request per second. So this is with a time gap and without a think time. So this report, which says that 2.6 request was hit within a second, was without any think time. And another where I have put some think time, random think time. So the execution report says that there is a total throughput of 2.6 requests per second. So because of this timer, our throughput also got changed and it has it's more than halved because of the think time. So this is the correct way how we should do generally what we do, because we all every time we used to implement this think time when we used to go with a production scenario. So now I'll show how to implement the pacing concept. So for pacing, first of all I'll be implementing through constant throughput timer, and the next I'll be implementing through shaping timer. So let's go with the first one. So here if I'll show you, I have used a constant throughput timer and I have said that target throughput should be 30 requests per minute, as it is in samples in minutes. So 30 requests per minute. Here if I'll say 1.2 requests per second, which will be more than around 70 requests per second per minute. But here I have said that in order to demonstrate how it goes, I have set a target of 30 requests per minute for all the active thread groups. Here also I have used the same requests, and here also I am using the with a think time. So I'll be comparing these results with this 1.2 requests per second, which was around 70 requests per minute, more than 70 requests per minute. And here with the help of pacing concept, I am controlling my execution till 30 requests per minute. So let me start the execution. And here I can show you the time gap. We can look into the time gap. First thread, the second thread, iteration 1. So it will take some time to complete the complete execution. And here the target throughput is of 30 requests per minute, so it's taking a long bit time to complete the execution. Let's go to go back again to our view results in a table. So I feel the test is going to complete. So let's move directly to our aggregate report. Here what we can see that the complete iteration. So once the test is completed, the throughput here, if we see the throughput is around 30 requests per minute. So if our server is able to handle the load which we have given, so it restrict the request which is coming. So it just put a time gap between sending each and every request, between each and every iteration. So we are restricting the request to a server to a 30 request per minute. Earlier it was around 70 requests per minute, but with the help of a constant throughput timer, I have restricted the request to 30 requests per minute, and which can be directly seen here with in a aggregate report. The same requests are being sent, and here the output is just 30 requests per minute. So at times we get a requirement where we need to set a TPS of 10 count or a 20 count, so that can be easily implemented with the help of a throughput shaping timer, as well as another timer with the help of which we can set our pacing, and that is an throughput shaping timer. So here what I have done, here I have designed in such a way that from 0 to 5 requests per second, it will take 5 seconds to reach. So it's a kind of a ramp up and ramp down scenario where I have increased my TPS count from 5 to 10. So 10 was my peak TPS count, and then finally reduce it to 5 and then to 0. So this is how we increase our load step by step, and then we execute our scenario in a peak load and then we ramp down. So I have implemented this. This is another way how we can implement the throughput pacing in JMeter if we know the count of TPS which we want to achieve while executing our test. Oh, I have cleared those, sorry. Okay, let's move with this one. So here I have used a dummy sampler, as I have earlier shown you that I was unable to achieve more than 2.6 requests per second where in without think time. So in order to achieve a 10 request per second, I have used a dummy sampler, and with the help of this I have able to achieve this. So the execution is on the way. So here I can show you. So this is how, with the help of a transaction per second, I can show how I have implemented the pacing with the help of a throughput shaping timer. So here I'm getting, so what I have done, I have initialized it to from 0 to 5 TPS per second, and for a 5 seconds. After that I took a 5 seconds to reach to a 10 TPS, my peak load, and executed that load for another 10 seconds. And after that I have ramped down, kind of the TPS count has come down to 5 seconds for another 5 seconds, and then again to 0. So with the help of this throughput shaping timer, I have implemented this. And if I go and show the aggregate report, so it's around 6.5 requests per second, which was not so this the throughput which I have got here with the help of dummy sampler was I was unable to achieve with this in this RES REQ site. So I have used the dummy sampler. So this is how the pacing comes. So mainly I need to explain you the throughput shaping timer, how it works. So here we can define our ramp up and ramp down, we can also define our ramp up the TPS count, and slowly we will reach our load, the peak TPS count, and then once our execution, the target is achieved, we can go and come down to zero slow and in few steps. So this is how we can implement the pacing in JMeter with the help of a constant throughput timer as well as a throughput shaping timer. So thank you everyone for watching this video. Hope you like the video, and please subscribe to my channel if you like my videos. Thank you everyone.